Welcome in. What up, what up, everyone? Appreciate you watching. Happy Saturday night. Welcome back to the channel. We are live, episode 17, NCAA Football 06 Next Edition. Shout out to the crew over there keeping this game fresh. We're taking on Kansas State with the Buffs tonight. Should be a dandy. Six and one against 5-2 with a win. We will likely crack the top 10 because there were some upsets, but this is not an easy pushover here with Kansas State, especially on the road. They're 5-2. What's up, Sean? Welcome in, man. We'll see how streaming tonight goes. The boys have been a little rough. With me as always, a little rough. Kirk Herbstreit.
The fans have dressed in layers, and we'll see some cold temps for the Colorado Buffaloes and the Kansas State Wildcats. We hope you're ready for an action-packed game of NCAA football. And here come the Wildcats. The Buffaloes come into this game expecting a win. I tend to agree with that. How about you, Herbie?
Colorado has one of their best players lining up in their backfield. Lee, expect a huge game from him running the football and maybe even catching a few passes. He's a tremendous athlete, and they'll use him as much as they can.
I've been quiet about this, but I think it's finally time for my pick.
The Buffs. Will the Buffs roll on the road?
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff.
What's up, James? I was just going to respond to you, too. Saw your message. Been a busy day of basketball.
Number 16 fields it at the 2.
Why does my controller feel broken? That's never a good sign. When you pop on for the first time in a while and you're like, wait a minute. Yeah, it's not working.
Number 8 with 3 wide receivers. On the ground with a tailback. Good move. And he's tackled. They'll get 2 on that one. Gain of
2 on the play. You don't have kids, you'll understand.
It's second down and 8, ball on the 22.
Someday you'll get it, where you're like, wait a minute, this button doesn't work all of a sudden. I haven't touched it.
Kansas State.
Nothing, nothing. Let's go, baby.
The defense comes up with a good play to pull him down for a loss.
A nice call by the defensive coordinator. It's like he's in their huddle sometimes.
Colorado has one of the toughest defenses we've seen.
I agree 100%. Just look at what they've done so far. Some very impressive numbers.
Now, this attacking defense is very, very athletic, and they're also well coached. That's why they're in the top 10.
Don't touch him.
Downtown. It falls incomplete. So the defense.
Oh, nice. Maxwell. What up, my man?
This incomplete pass.
How have you been?
They line up to punt this one away. It's off, and it is a dandy.
Should have fair caught it. The Buffs looking good. What if we make the natty with both these teams? The only reason I would is because I play this game so much.
The Buffs go with the I formation. Phillips, options out to the right. And now he's got room to run. And they make the stop.
I feel like Colorado can make it this year.
Second and one.
As long as we don't have any goofy stuffy happen to us.
Phillips is back in the gun. He steps up.
Ooh.
Across the middle. It's tipped.
Ooh.
He's lucky that pass fell innocently to the turf.
Yep, total coverage on that one. Got to pick his destinations better.
It's third down and a yard for the first down. Ball on the 43.
You got to be in at 6:30 tomorrow morning, James?
The Buffalo come out in a 2 tight end set. Makes a move. And down he goes.
Why do we have an X factor?
He was just following
for an impact.
Hey,
they're
moving the sticks.
Fullback. Click and scroll, I can't let you go. They say I'm addicted to you. Click and scroll, I can't let you go. They say I'm addicted to you. Oh, oh, this ain't love, no, no. This ain't love, no, no. This is a... What's up, Joey? Welcome in, man.
Colorado comes out with an eye.
Colorado State's not going to get the same.
Con los terroristas.
Come on, Jameis. Oh! Come on. It's good! The Buffs with a 50. I love the support tonight, fellas. See you coming in. Showtime Sports. Joey, what's up, man? How you been?
He puts it deep downfield. Number 16 fields it in the end zone. Tries to juke.
You guys remember what this offense did? I'll be getting a YouTube member stream in this weekend, too, so keep an eye out for that. We're almost done with the season, man. Crazy. Sports Network, how many games do you play a day? Three, four? Missed tackle again.
And down he goes. Pickup of a yard for the tailback. 1 yard gain on the play. It's second down and nine to go. Ball on their own 23.
That's awesome, man.
The Wildcat come out showing three wide, throws, and it's caught, brought down. That'll
this series working out. 1 yard gain on the play. I'm having a good time with it. I don't know.
Ball on their own 24. Number eight is back in the gun on the ground.
I think the natty will be amazing.
He has some room, and they make the stop, and they get a nice gain on third down. Remember when
we talked to the coach? Because what I'm going to do is people that donated to be on a team, if they're on the national championship team, then I'm going to put those guys in some sort of, I don't know, maybe like a UFC tournament or something.
They'll bring him down.
Or they'll win a giveaway.
Second and nine coming up here, and this is the fifth play.
And that, I think, will be really fun. A fun way to cap it off.
Kansas State lines up with three receivers. He drops back. He's going left. Oh, great catch. And down he goes.
I like the defense that was called. They just didn't make the play on the ball.
You're right. It wasn't necessarily a bad defense. The offense just executed, and the result is the first
But round. YouTube Shorts, yeah, people Number really do like. That is honestly, that might be the way to go.
Steps up in the pocket, throws. He might have a chance.
Way to look it in. Nice catch.
Sure was. He displayed some great hands there. Now we're looking at a first down.
It's defense not looking so good now. Kansas State marching it. Formation. Nice play, I knew he was going to catch that.
Across the middle. He's got his tight end.
Nice decision by the quarterback.
Not only was it good decision making, but the offensive line protected just long enough for him to find his target.
And when you combine the two, it'll be a first down 9 out of 10 times.
Number eight with three wide receivers. Drop back to pass. End zone.
Oh my gosh.
Touchdown, Kansas State. Outstanding play to the wide receiver as he took it the distance.
10 streams a day. Jeez. Me and my son were playing the other day. We were playing Deliver Us to the Moon. It's borderline stream game. Like, it's a borderline some of you would probably be like, I like this a lot. This is cool. And I think it'd be boring for some of you. So we've just been playing it off there. And it is kind of interesting. It's easy to figure out, I will say. Like, it's got some, like, interesting, like, you know, you end up in space and you got to try to deliver everyone to the moon and save this plant type thing. I don't know. But then you got to continue to get oxygen tanks because you're in space, whatever it is. I don't know. And then fix this. We were taking energy from the moon. Yeah, we were taking energy from the moon to survive. Earth is like desolate, and we're trying to move everyone.
It's third down and 8 to go.
Yeah, Sean, we keep talking about doing It Takes Two, man. We keep talking about it. We just haven't.
He drops back, gives a little pump fake, looking. He's going right.
Oh, Sprock.
And they tackle him, and they convert the third down with a long
Yeah, that Hogwarts does look good.
That was a long pass play. As a coach, you got to appreciate it when your players come out and
I will agree.
Like these kids
that does
do
look
right
really
now.
Interesting.
First and 10.
There's been some good games been released.
Going with the shotgun here. Here's the option. Big opening.
Take what you can get, Phillips.
Nice running on the
must score drive here, boys.
Option keeper there. And I'm
must
tell you
score drive.
Like that play was going
I want to get down.
But this quarterback made the right
132 and 3. You know what,
right.
Sean? We almost played it tonight, but they, Big Mac and his sister wanted to watch a movie.
Little shake and bake move. Brought down. 7 yards there.
You want to play It Takes Two? You do? Now he says, he hears me talking about it.
And this is the sixth
like, yeah, I want to play.
The Buffalo line up with two tight ends. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Tackle. And that was a nice
it's the most. You think it's the most played game on?
Yeah,
what?
It really was, Brad. And also,
should I
nice
just start? Should I download it right now? When you break one like
that,
you got to give a lot of credit to the offense. I wouldn't have the slightest thing what to do.
This is the seventh play of this drive.
I'd pop it in. I'd be like, where's the first down marker at?
The ace set here. They'll drop him for a loss. Excellent
Hogwarts Legacy.
That time as they swallowed him up before he got back to the line.
It's more like they
how do I throw a halfback no screen in this?
Second and 11 coming up.
Grant, who do they play the first round? I didn't see it. I heard it was released, though. It's probably OC.
Back in the gun. Back to pass.
On.
He gives a pump fake. Looks.
Oh, no.
Oh, what an interception. And down he goes. And they come up with a big play there, don't they?
Yeah, my wife really liked it, Maxwell.
Defense looks very well coached on that one. That's what happens when 11 ball-hawking defenders go full speed.
The Wildcats come out in the ace formation.
Ooh, these stupid sliding catches. Six straight completions?
Second and 6, ball on 34.
We're going to lose? Upset right, alert?
With three wide receivers. He's looking. Down the middle.
Didn't catch that sliding pass.
Big reception that time, guys.
Just let that one get away from his vision just for a split second.
Now it's third and 6 coming up. Ball on the 34-yard line. They better block that linebacker. He is looking to make something happen. And he stopped behind the line.
They sent the blitz and drilled the running back before he could find any daylight.
Oakland, 10:45 at the Devaney. What? You don't play at a Lincoln school?
Number 17 gets it off.
I'm telling you.
Takes it to 25, and he's hit hard. So before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know.
Oakland's man defense, if it's on point, I'm telling you.
They'll go to work at the 30-yard line.
It's the best I'd seen all year when it was on point, but then it was off really bad the next day in the game. So hard telling.
Handoff up the middle. He might have a chance. He spins, knocked out of bounds. Picked up big yards there, and he's going to have a first down.
Yeah, nice job there. This guy does a good job in reading his blocks and accelerating through the hole.
Indiana beat Purdue?
Ball on their own 48.
Jeez.
Colorado.
The game I watched today that I could not believe.
Sets up the play action over the middle.
I could not believe my eyes.
Could have easily been a turnover.
Florida State, Miami.
Saw that guy.
Well, he almost saw him running the other direction with the
unbelievable.
Second and 10.
Ball on the 48-yard line. Miami was just rolling. Lost the game.
They'll work from the shotgun. They'll run the option. And he's tackled. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
And that was just good instincts. You have to know when to pitch it or when to keep it.
Yeah, and in that situation, the quarterback knew he could pick up the first, so he kept it himself. Very good decision.
The Buffs come out in the shotgun. Phillips, options out to the left. And he's drilled. The option keeper gets him 2, maybe 3 yards.
I haven't really pushed the ball downfield, have I? Well, here it comes. Here comes my YOLO. 30-point comeback, yes.
Colorado lines up with 3 receivers. Bad snap.
Wow, look at K-State at home.
Yeah, the offensive line couldn't adjust to them, sending the added pressure. The result was a nice play for the defensive end. You're absolutely right. Those big
K-State at home making some noise.
Third down, 15.
Yeah, that was a crazy intense comeback. I could not believe it. What is happening?
Drops back to back, pumps once, floats this one right side.
Oh my gosh, that's usually a catch.
The drive stalls and they'll have to punt it away.
That's really bad. That is a 1 yard punt.
Up there. And this one's going to go out of bounds.
Might have lost. That might be a negative yards.
Not a whole lot of success there last
time
out. Not at all. This offense has to do a better job of staying on the field and giving their defense a chance to catch their breath.
That was horrible.
In a 5-wide set. They'll throw on first down. Fires it quickly. And he can't hang on.
What is this penalty?
There's a flag down and here's the ball.
Touching a little single team.
It's loss of down.
With everybody running around so fast down there, I don't know how you
doesn't matter. They complete anyway. Would have been second down and 10.
So it's second and 10. Ball right around midfield. Kansas State sets up in the eye.
Go get him. Boom. Fumble it.
Nothing faked it.
Let's go.
I'm out. Great speed to find his way to the quarterback.
You know, if I were the coach, I'd line this kid up a defensive end every now and then.
Wow, can you imagine that?
EA Sports. It's in the game.
Absolutely.
I like that. I like that, Kirk.
He drops back, steps up, looking across the middle.
Are you kidding me?
What an amazing catch. First down.
Boy, Brad, you said it. That is a big-time play there. Spectacular catch and great body control there on the long pass reception.
I knew this game was
going to line up in the shotgun.
That spooked me a little bit.
And the snap goes to the back. Brought down. Kansas State calls a timeout.
Second on the road,
ball on the 25-yard
Manhattan,
line.
Tough place to play.
The Wildcats come out in the ace formation, back to pass. Looks, rolling out to the right side, throws this one out to the right.
I like the defense that was called. They just didn't make the play on the ball.
You're right. It wasn't necessarily bad defense. The offense just executed, and the result is a first down.
Kansas State comes to the line with 3 wide. Drops back to pass.
Burn him.
To the outside.
Wow.
He brings it down. Touchdown. Nice play call on that one to get the ball in the receiver's hand.
Yeah, quarterback says, you want the ball, go get it. Did he ever? He got it and took it for 6.
Got some work to do.
And he hits the PAT. And now we're going to take a look at the Pontiac drive summary. Kansas State lines up for the kickoff. Number 11 and number 26 set to return. And he got all of this one. Great kick. Number 11 fields it in the end zone. And now a slight break.
This too. Jeepers.
The Buffs come out in a 2 tight end set. Line up with 2 tight ends. Going deep, lays it out there. It falls incomplete. He sailed that one high.
That's not a bad incompletion because he saw the blitz coming and just got rid of the ball to avoid losing yardage.
So it's 2nd and 10. Ball on their own 18. They come out with 3 wide receivers. They go with the option. Laterals back. He tries to spin. And down he goes. Colorado takes a timeout.
7-yard gain on the play.
We get third and three.
That'll work.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line.
Audio Jungle.
The Buffs come out showing three wide. Rolls right. Deep pass down the right side. The freshman takes the pass.
You're trying to do. I get it. All good. There it is. So halftime, Kansas State up 14-10, shocking the nation.
And that'll do it for the first half of play.
Better get it together. Better get it together, boys.
Kansas State will be kicking off to start the second half. Nice kick, plenty of distance.
Thanks, Sean.
Number 26 fields it in the end zone. And now
all right, here we go.
Coming out of the field for their next possession.
So funny.
He's going to pitch it. He cuts up the field and keeps the ball himself.
No question, coach. Great execution
and a good decision there by the quarterback.
You are trash and you know it.
Looking,
rolling
out the left side.
Is here on nine.
Going down deep and
oh my gosh, that's so old.
Wow, nice catch.
Way to look it in. Heck of a job by the wide receiver. These guys are moving the ball down the field.
Jeez, he sounds really little.
Ball on the 26. They'll work from the shotgun. Phillips, options out to the right. And now he pitches it. And down he goes. The tailback picks up about 3 yards on the option play. The second down and
yeah, Thad. Thad, you got to time that out like when it's a first and 10 for the offense.
Two tight end set.
For the CPU. Otherwise, might get caught in a bad situation. That was probably the most enjoyable stream ever.
Colorado comes out with two tight ends.
Whatever got us to stream that either.
He might have a chance. Yahoo, tackle.
This is one of those uh-oh plays for the defense. Not only do you not stop them on third down, you give up big gainer on the ground. Uh-oh.
Oh boy, nice option play there against that defense.
The Buffs go with the I formation. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. He breaks free. Touchdown, Buffalo.
There we go.
Powerful run by the halfback to reach Hader.
Yeah, he's hot. Keep giving him the run.
Little Mac with the old, what is that, Big Mac? Big Mac or Little Mac?
and he hits the PAT. So with just over
has someone ever played you?
17, Kansas State 14. Colorado to kick, number 10 and number 16 back deep to return.
Someone has never agreed to play you, has he?
Decent kick, looks to be returnable. Number 10, pass it at the 5, at the 30. And now a slight break in the action.
Gosh, you know what? That is a game I should be playing.
They'll go to work at the 36.
That is a game I should be playing, honestly.
Kansas State comes out with an eye
formation. I should get my...
Yes, sir! Slip and slide records. We can take it to the highs. Just get on up and get down.
All of my people all across the world.
Brought down to the open field, so they execute and move a little closer to the sticks.
Yeah, completing those short passes is the key.
Summit's never agreed to play you, huh?
To sleep a little bit. Then you can launch one big one downfield for a big game.
Oh, is that when we actually did release Brett Rowley and then he got really mad?
Back to pass, steps up in the pocket, throws down the middle.
I think he might have, like, stopped watching the channel because I did. And it seriously wasn't, it wasn't, like, nothing against him. It was the player was not doing very well. I remember that. Don't be mad. It's just a video game player that's not doing well. But he's back now. He's back. We're all good.
Let's see if they go to him again.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 38.
We're on good terms now that Brett Rowley was released.
Phillips is back in the gun.
Oh, was that?
Up the middle.
What game was that? Was that Madden 09? Creative team?
So they give it to the fullback, and he's able to get him 8 on the carry. Second and 2 coming up here. Ball on the 30-yard line.
Who's that? Madden 09.
The impact player at running back is
okay. Okay, fullback.
A little juke. Brought down. Maybe a few, but that's it.
Nothing. Nothing doing. We're going to do the same thing.
There's a place up ahead, and I'm going just as fast as my feet can fly. Come away, come away, and get going. Leave the sinking ship behind. Come on.
Taken down.
Oh, FSU. Yeah. That might be it. But yeah, I should break out NCAA 14.
And this is the sixth play of the drive.
I think I'm still Texas, ain't we?
Colorado lines up in a double tight set.
Wow, Grant with the broken tackle. Can he get in?
And that one goes for a big, big first down.
You know, every time you run the ball successfully like that, that defense starts to creep up a little bit. That's when you go to the air, my friend. Over the top.
It might have been Washington State, yeah.
Down there. Touchdown, Colorado. There's number 2 on the day.
The coach loves to give the football to this
running
back. You know why? Because he knows how to find the end zone.
It could have been Wazoo, yeah.
And he tacks on the extra point. That score leads us to our Pontiac drive summary.
I remember he was really upset about it. I do remember that.
Number 29 looks ready to kick this one off.
Do I?
He kicks it.
Do I bring back 14 and play a little bit? Gosh, I just haven't played in a long time. After I heard that the new college football game is delayed, I was like, you know what? I'll take a little break from it. That was my thought. Because I'm like, you know what? We're going to have a long time left playing this. Football Manager is great. Football Manager is fun.
They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Dukes. They'll bring him down, and it looks like there's an injury.
Got an injury. I don't know how much. See, the thing is, I don't know how much love it would get. You know.
Third down.
We might bring in some new viewers, but
the Wildcats come to the line with their jumbo package.
And you can flip through that pretty fast. Oh my gosh. How did he connect on that one?
I'll tell you what, he really wanted that first down. Good determination again.
I thought that was easy incomplete.
Kansas State comes to the line with three wide. Here's the give. Tackle. He picked up around 3 yards on the draw play. So that brings us to the end of the quarter. And at the end of three, our score, Colorado 24, Kansas State 14. Second and seven coming up here. And this is the fifth play of the
quarter. I like
drive.
Football Manager because you can get through games quickly if you really want to. Pick it off. Oh.
The ball is tipped. The ball is knocked to the ground.
Players use anything they can to get in the way of a pass.
The offense faces
but I appreciate your guys' support, man.
And the man at wideout
is in a zone
right now.
Don't stop.
Back to pass. Steps up. Looks. Over the middle. Finds his receiver. And down he goes. First and 10. Ball on the 41.
Yes, 14 online dynasty still work.
Single set back to you. Again with a carry. They'll bring him down.
My group.
That'll be a gain of 10 by the running.
My group of guys. They've all agreed to get back together when the new game come out. Like I hit them all up, and they're like, I'm in. And we were together for like 10 years, a long time, like real life 10 years. So many different kinds of dynasties that we played. Played like rags to riches, where we'd all start with one star and work our way up through carousel. We would do powers that be, which everybody picked a powerhouse. Did Big Ten only, SEC only. Those were so fun.
He steps up, he's looking. Throw short, couldn't haul it in. Dropped by the wideout.
And then we kind of stopped because they shut down the webpage. And when they shut the webpage down, like the, I don't know. I wish the website was still up, man. That thing was golden. So, does anybody remember the NCAA 14 website?
When you have a guy that can grab 5 yards or so consistently, it sure takes some of the pressure off the
You could recruit and cut players from the website. So, like we would start our coaching carousel and no one was at home. And since I was a commish, I could advance it. Like, from my phone, using the website. Because they used to have an NCAA website.
Throws a lob pass out to the right.
For 14.
Tackle. They get a yard on the play.
And we would do all of our coaching carousel from our phones away from home. So we got home. It was all done.
The Wildcats.
Yeah, they had a website for the online dynasty portion. It was so good. You literally could do everything from the website. It was not the Team Builder website. They had a Dynasty website. EA did. It was EA Sports / Dynasty. And you could do everything from it. You could even play the games. But it was like play calling, and it was a little goofy, and I think they cut it out. But you could even do that. It was so amazing. And then, because like, most of our guys, like, so, like, get this. It's like, you know, every week you would recruit. I can't believe nobody knows about this. This is crazy. This is the biggest part of our dynasty. So what was awesome was somebody would text me, and they'd be like, Mac, dude, this dynasty we had was freaking elite. I'm telling you. We had a website. We had all kinds of stuff. It's called College Game Day Dynasty. We had a Twitter. Breaking news. I pretty much ran all of it. And we did podcasts, interviewed coaches. We had fake interviews. Or we would, like, imitate a coach and, like, we'd come up with funny stuff.
Here's the option.
Like, I don't know, we made fun of one guy because he was in Wisconsin. All he talked about was cheese. But the website, so like I would advance from my phone, and then you get an email. If you had your email, because obviously you had to use your email login, it would send you an email and say, league has been advanced. Right? And on the advancement email, it would tell you the game results of what happened in your online dynasty, and it would tell you who committed that week. I'm not kidding. It would tell you who committed for each team. If you have Joe Montana, the best quarterback that ever lived, 16 for life. But they have that website. I would advance at work, and I would do my recruiting on my phone. So when I got home, all I had to do was play my game. I didn't have to do my recruiting points. And that was worth so much. And then apparently they took the web page down, or they kept the web page up.
He tosses it short. Incomplete pass. This incompletion is credited to the wideout.
Absolutely. But it wouldn't let you log in anymore, and we were all super bummed and disappointed.
Ball on their own 38. Colorado lines up with five.
Yeah, did all my recruiting and not even at home. Pick it, please. Thank you very much.
And he drops it. Dropped by the wideout.
Yeah, the Twitter. I don't think I deleted it. Let me look for it.
Third and 10. Ball on the 38.
We were established in 2009. Let's look at it after the game. How about that? I'll pull it up on the screen.
Going with the shotgun here. Drops back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. Looks.
Atta boy.
The ball is tipped. Not on target.
They're going to punt? I got three timeouts.
The Wildcat set up in the gun.
Bro.
What's up, Jazz? What's up, Nick? Thanks for the thumbs up, everyone. Yeah, we'll look at my online dynasty Twitter. Oh.
Got an opening. Brought down. Kansas State takes a timeout.
Con los terroristas.
Touchdown. Let's see if the defense can hold them this time.
Gotta be game, boys.
Not too much there on that run.
Not too much.
Grant, you're still in here. We'll look at it.
As much time as possible.
I'll talk about it. I can probably remember every post I ever did from this thing, too.
It's second down and 8 to go. Ball on the 15-yard line.
Oh, Madalena's going to hit the portal. Madalena's got the portal. He's already complaining.
Colorado comes to the line. Only one man in the backfield.
What did he say last time? He said something. I can't remember what it was.
He's hit and got away, and he stopped behind the line.
It was funny.
He couldn't get past those big linemen.
You got that right. They sacrificed their bodies in there and stuffed it.
Yeah, I mean, I like the stream. So sometimes then I notice I like it, and then I dislike it. Oh, okay. That's cool. Touche.
It's up. And it is good. Let's take it.
Colorado's going to escape.
Drive somewhere.
Yep, Colorado. Nick, same here. That state refund, boy, I'll tell you what. It got me, too. Apparently, they need some roads to fix in Nebraska.
The offense saw their last drive end on fourth down. Will we see a similar result this time?
There is a portal one. Yeah, there's Prime. I got a Prime redeem.
Lets it fly, and it's caught. Got an opening, and down he goes.
Way to look at it.
It ain't gonna be no more of the mess that these wonderful fans, the student body, and some of your parents have put up with for probably 2 decades now. I'm coming. And when I get here, it's gonna be change. So I want y'all to get ready to go ahead and jump in that portal and do whatever you're gonna get. Because the more you jump in, the more room you make. Because we bring kids that are smart. Say that, smart.
Smart.
Tough.
How'd that make you feel? Sitting there. Pondering your future. Well, I guess my time at Colorado's done. Okay, here it is. So this is my online dynasty. So Summit Husker was in this for many years. Established it in 2009. That's when we started this thing. And then I had so many random people. I probably saved them. I know I saved them because they're hilarious. Of like elderly people that would send me a DM begging me to go to their college for college game day. Like they thought they were DMing college game day. And I'm sure I saved them. I don't remember my login. That's the problem. But anyway. Yeah, this was it. This was our last... This is my last banner I made. Golden Taters. That's what I called him. Called him Golden Taters. For some reason, this is not fitting in the screen here. Hold on. There's Golden Taters. I did retweet this back in 2021. Gosh, that was 2 years ago. That's crazy. EM Hags winning season one national championship. Summit Husker had coach Summit. This guy plays for my defense. We stink. Oh, man. And then kickoff, Coach Summit, season is underway. Penn State takes on Wake Forest. And then I had a YouTube link because they would stream the games. They had their own coaching. LSU Tigers got off to a rocky start with freshman Max Johnson under center. Former five-star running back John Emery Jr. carried the load. That's when Summit took over Penn State. This was after... this is when we started it back up in 2020. And guys were doing the draft, so I was reporting on the draft. So SB Coach is a huge Oklahoma fan. And he took over Texas, so we all freaked out. Canes have their guy, Kyle. Kyle's a great dude. I wonder what he's been up to. I need to text him. Kyle Markham. Jeez. Summit went to Penn State. First pick. Pag picked the Trojans. Draft is complete. One spot open in the Game Day Dynasty. Starting this weekend. 11th year. That's when we started our 11th year of doing College Game Day, 2020. Oh, here's Lucas O. The longest NCAA football league going. Game Day NCAA run by BRM podcast keeps going. That was Lucas O. That's how I met Lucas O. My good buddy Lucas O. You guys have seen him. You guys saw him. All right, in the chat. Giveaway. Oh, the beta code. Coach Summit must have lost week one. Game Day coach. Who is this? New coach alert. Saturn Sky, the former head coach of Boise, officially announced as TCU OC. Wild. He's still not allowed within 5 miles of any elementary school. Can TCU make this work and only find a place to live? More on this developing story. Oh, stupid. Summit, we maximized at TCU. We were hired to take a program to the next level. Rumors aside, we love TCU. As Michigan struggled, they reached out to us week 8. My only concern was, at the time, was TCU, but in the end, we couldn't turn them down. Go blue. They went to Michigan. So are you denying rumors that a secret meeting prior to week 2 did not happen? And why did your wife accept a job outside of Ann Arbor 2 weeks ago? Oh my gosh, this is actually funny. Robbie, what's up? This is good. Rumors running wild as to why he left TCU. Some say it's Creighton. Some say the Big 12 is only big enough for one. Butthead, just spoke to the man directly. It's a video game. You do you. More on this developing story. Breaking news. Less than 24 hours after national championship game, Michigan has offered a breaking 5-year deal with former TCU BCS national championship coach Eric Bieniemy. Harbaugh is out. Bieniemy is in. He heads north with a bag full of cash and a shiny new trophy. Oh, yeah, I used to make these, too. I made these pictures. This is where I learned my Photoshop stuff. Oh, yeah, the do-it-all halfback from South Carolina is the talk of the country right now. Looks like it's his Heisman to lose. I'd post Heisman updates. There's also other people that would post on this. I can't remember who else it was. There was two other people that were posting on this. Lucas, oh, you got to remember this, man. Oh, that's when I was USD. I took over USD. Took over South Dakota. I think I have one of them games saved on YouTube, actually. But we, yeah, I think we gave everybody the login, and they could log in and post. Syracuse. And in the most surprising news, Saturn Sky makes a bowl game. That's right. He lost like 20 games in a row. Oh, this is when I took on Arkansas. I think this is the game. I think this is the game that I actually streamed on YouTube, and then I think I hid this. I think it's hidden. I cleaned up my channel. But this goes back forever. Like, literally. Oh, the recruiting class rankings. This was cool. I made this. I got the number one. I got the number one recruiting class. Somehow, not one of the top five players in the nation, though. South Alabama signed the number one athlete. I still remember that. Still makes me mad. Arkansas. I don't remember who Arkansas was. Let me keep looking here. Dude, they'd post their player profiles. Look at this. Of dudes that they had committed. Talk about them. Gotta go back a little further, though. Oh, I used to post the transfer list. I'd always post the transfer list. Just to show people. This is like when I was, if I was at work, I'd post this so people could see who left. That way they're always in touch with everything. We had games of the week. Jeez, we're going way back now. We had hot seat rankings. Look at this. Hot seat rankings. Who was on the hot seat? So people knew. What else? There are so many different things. So many different things. Ah. How do we have 265 followers? Jeepers. Yeah, it was fun. We had a really good time with that. But all my boys are back. We're just waiting. We'll get fired on up, and I'm sure we'll have an opening. Or two. Or three. We're usually about eight, nine strong. And we've been playing together since 2009. So, gosh, I wish I could read. Hold on. I got to see if I can log into this. I don't even remember. I got to log in and read you some of these comments from people. Some of them were, like, very upset. Like, very upset. Because, like, how dare you talk about our team like that on game day? And then I'd send a message back, and I'm like, this is a video game. We're a video game. We're a video game. I can't log in. To sign in with Google or Apple. Oh, maybe this is it. Oh, we even had Game Day Kirk. That's right. We even had Kirk Herbstreit reporting. Oh my gosh, I'm in. I'm logged in. Here it is. There was a young lady who always commented on her team's injuries. Please put Coastal Carolina up higher. With the win this weekend, we don't have any losses. Please pay attention to our games. Hold on. That kid's like, I lost my save file. Can you help me? Can I join? I got PS3. Be sure to give some coverage to Virginia Tech's retiring D coordinator, Bud Foster, either today when he's being honored at home, which would be common sense, or before the end of the season, please. Her name was Barb. Hold on. The next one. This one is from Carnita. Carnita, who is a high school mathematics teacher, says, I hope you mention the 10th anniversary of Dabo being made interim head coach. She sent me that back in 2018. Gosh, there was one. That I replied to. Oh yeah, go Ducks. Wow. Game Day crew. You all got that one wrong. Here's another one. Wow. I am utterly embarrassed to have this on my TV. You continually pass on our school, even though we are one of the top 100 all-time winningest programs in this sport. It sure would be nice to get some of the respect the Blue Bloods do. Man, what a blast this was. Dude, this is so fun. So fun to play. I can't even tell you how intense it is. It's so intense. Oh, and then we had, on top of this, we had, let me think if I can remember what it's called. Like, we took this serious, y'all. Like, this was big. What is it called? Oh, there it is. So it was called the Gridiron Gamers Pro Boards. So then we had this. And on this, we would chat. We'd post our rules and AI settings. We'd discuss those. Team info, so if you need to text anybody, you have their information. They would talk about Wally's past All-American teams. Man, I miss him a lot. Wally's a great dude, but he had some kids and put it in the water. He was done. He would write up his own All-American teams, and then he would write up, like, he'd even have others that were, like, honorable mention. You have athlete. And then I had a wall of champions somewhere. Smack talk, the blue chip report, scheduling request. If you guys had a request. Now, I think we started using GroupMe instead. Hey, there's the wall of champions, bye-bye. NCAA 12. So this NCAA 12, I was Kentucky. This was all SEC. I won the championship three times. Nick Davis, who's actually a college football coach now, down in Kansas at Ottawa, I think, or something like that. We had a Big Ten dynasty. I ran that sucker with Purdue. Then we played Pac-12. I was the only one to win that championship. Summit's in here somewhere. Powers that be, Buffalo. Well, that's when I was Buffalo? I won the championship with Northern Illinois. Oh, then I lost to Kings. Kings is SB coach's son. Then I went to Florida State and rocked him three times in a row. Oh, there's Gotch. Gotch won it with Notre Dame. I remember that. On a last second Hail Mary. Yeah, Grant, this is where all my subs came from. when I first started out on YouTube, with all these guys. Head coach only, that's right. Oh my gosh, this Big 12 dynasty, I remember I was Baylor, won the title, and then Kings had like a number one recruiting class in his first year at Kansas. He was such a tough out. That kid was so good at this game, man. Nick Davis in our SEC years. Kookie Bots, what's up? In our SEC years, all he did was run fullback dive. That's all he did. He ran fullback dive on NCAA 12. It's unstoppable. Seriously. You play NCAA 12, run fullback dive. It's worth 8 yards a carry every single time. Like, it's stupid. Seriously dumb. Kookie, thanks for your work on this game, man. It's phenomenal. So Colorado goes to 7-1, boys. We've got Colorado State taking on New Mexico. I had a dream. I lost that game. That's when you know you're probably streaming too much, or maybe, I don't know, I mean, that's not the case, but I guess this game gets in your mind. Can't get it out. All right, there it is. I'm going to see if I'll see if my son here in a little bit wants to play. It takes two. We need to finish that. No problem, man. Thanks for the love. Glad to see people enjoying it. Oh, my gosh, dude, I'm loving it. I'm actually, you know what, Cookie, I'm going to tell you this. So, forgive me, I'm not a PCSX2 expert. Oh, Grant, Cookie's like a creator of this thing. He's a legend of NCAA Next. He is a legend. He's the guy. But, like, you know, on PCSX, whatever, you can, like, up the speed of the game. I don't know what setting that is, but it plays faster. I like that you can do that with an emulator. You know what I'm saying? I know. I'm not super good with that stuff, but I love that I up the speed of the game, so it's actually so much faster than playing it on PS2. Like, the game's just more, I don't know. I don't know how to explain it, but you know what I'm talking about. I love that part, because just, I don't know, the game looks just, I don't know, it's faster. It runs faster. Not that it's slow on 06 on PS2, but I do like that you can up the processor speed of it a little bit. So much faster. All right. It might be 30 minutes or so, but I'll be back with something. With something. Appreciate you all. Thanks for the, man, you guys showed up tonight. I appreciate that very much so. 11 likes, right around 10 all night. That's great. For some retro gaming, man, I'll take it. Boston College is what? Gross. Virginia Tech almost pulled a comeback, though. Almost. All right, boys. Do all those guys have revamped? Oh, Grant. They are. Dude, them guys are working on. What else did you guys just talk about releasing? What was it? Madden 08 next. Madden 05 next. They're unreal. Madden 08 next. Preseason rosters for 22. Updated coaching. Updated salary cap. CBA salary structure. Superstar and franchise modes work out of the box. Import draft classes from 06 next. I can't even keep up. Added 40-second play clocks. Fixed the Washington Commanders. Moved touchbacks to the 25-yard line. My mouth drools, and then they're almost like a, what are they like? It's like a Christmas when you open a present and it's your favorite one, but then you got another present and you open that and you love that even more, and then all of a sudden you look down and there's six more, and then it's like they constantly throw Christmas presents under the tree. And you start getting overwhelmed as a retro gamer, you know? It's like, I can't open anymore! Like, it's amazing. Updated NFL rosters through the trade deadline. Scaled down salaries to improve AI signings. Signing issues with modern salaries. Updated cities for all the teams. Made SoFi Stadium for the Rams and Chargers. Superstar mode now works with 2022 roster. Like, the updates are just, we've never seen anything like this, which is sad. Coming from just normal, regular guys, you know, that aren't a dev team. They're the best dev team ever. What? No, not yet. What else did they just do? They just did something else that just blew my mind. What was it, Kookie? I'm trying to... What did they do for next? Gosh, let me see if I can find it. They added in... Gosh, what was it? Something really just... This one? Coaching mod that allows CPU advanced stat tracking and firing. A coaching carousel mod. Coaching carousel mod. Added week zero. Added the 12 game scheduling system. Added the playoff, conference championship games without divisions. Yeah, they got the playoff mod. NIL. NIL recruiting pitches. Kooky, my question is this. Will they continue doing this if the new college football game comes out? Or do you think it'll be done? I would imagine they would. I think it's a super dedicated group that actually love this game. I think the love for the game is so deep, I don't think it's going to. I don't see why we wouldn't. I agree. It makes me happy. Because I have a feeling people are going to be really disappointed with that, and they're going to be right back playing. Yes, Grant. NIL on 06. I just don't have any of the I don't have them updates, but it's cheapers. You talk about these guys are just insane. I gotta get the playoff. I gotta get that done. The only reason I didn't is because I want it to be really hard for Colorado and Colorado State to both get in the championship. Cookies on year 84. Yes, he is insane. It's a nuts. 84 years. 84. Oh, man. I'll get there when I'm like 90. Cookie, man, I appreciate your support, man. Keep doing your thing. All right. I'll try to be back with something in a little bit. Much love, y'all. We'll see you on the next one. We'll see what it is yet. If I don't see you back, have a good night. Cookie is the GOAT. There's so much that goes on behind the scenes. Just trying to figure out how to edit things. Doing things now that thought were impossible. Probably going to have to keep up even if a new NCAA comes out. Yeah, it's crazy. I never thought you guys would be able to do some of the stuff that you've done. Never. I appreciate it. Thank you, Kooky. Thanks for stopping in, too, man. Check out his channel. Peace.